Alright guys, new year, new me, but what have I learned so far after my first term in Waterloo's computer engineering program? That's what I'm going to talk about in this video. So other than that, let's get this started, guys. Alright, let's get the boring stuff out of the way and talk about courses. So in computer engineering, we take 7 courses, which is a lot, but that also means that we learn a lot. First course, Arts 190, Communications for Engineering. We don't learn that much in this course, but one of the key takeaways is learning how to write conference papers as well as technical communication. Another course that we have is ECE 190. So this is our Engineering Profession and Ethics course. As you can tell from the name, we learn about the ethics and different professions within engineering, and we do a bunch of fun team building activities within the course. We also learned about some interesting engineering accidents and how we could have solved them, like the 1907 Quebec bridge failure. All right, next up, ECE 105, Classical Mechanics. Now, this is probably one of our hardest courses, and it's pretty much just high school physics, but on steroids. And we just cover topics from kinematics to rolling motion. There's actually some interesting concepts and problems that we did, but it wasn't anything really too applicable. All right, next up, we got Math 115, which is linear algebra. This is pretty much just high school vectors with matrices, and we just learned stuff from scalar projections to subspace proofs to like orthonormal bases. Math 117 is Calculus 1 for engineers. So this is just high school calculus, but just sped up pretty much. And you learn everything from differentiation to integration methods like IBP, U sub, and trig sub, and etc. And then you also learn about like polar coordinates and applications of integrals. And then we also have ECE 150. So this is fundamentals of programming. And we just learned for loops, sorting algorithms, binary search, and linked lists. And then our last course is ECE 198, which is our engineering project course. So we use something called the STM32 board to create a project. In this course, you do some basic wiring to create a project, and then most of the learning is doing some documentation for the progress of your project, but mostly you have to learn everything on your own. You don't actually learn any of the wiring or even the programming, so you have to learn everything and search it up on the internet on your own, which actually leads me to the next point. Everything can be learned from the internet. Classical mechanics, calculus, linear algebra, programming, and pretty much every single course can be learned on the internet. After pretty much your first week of university, you'll soon learn that professors are not needed at all, and essentially everything that you need is on the internet, and you can just search up every single thing pretty much. One joke that everyone likes saying is that organic chemistry tutor or Khan Academy are our actual professors. Calculus. But yeah, pretty much you only need your professors when you need questions answered and pretty much everything like that. Now, another important lesson that I learned was maintaining good physical health and sleep. Now, this is a pretty obvious one, but a lot of people in university sometimes struggle with this, and this was something that I struggled with. Sometimes I would sacrifice my sleep and only get 6 hours of sleep, or maybe even 5 hours of sleep. But then what I found was that in the lectures the day after, I was unable to pay attention and focus because I was too tired. And then afterwards, I would just go back to my room, nap, and then I was losing a lot of time because of the sleep that I lost the day before. And then it was just pretty much a game of catch up, and I had to catch up on the lectures, stay up late again, and blah, 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 until the weekend came, and then I was able to finally catch up on that. So yeah, in addition to that, I was also sacrificing a lot of time to go to the gym. So my goal was to go to the gym at least 3 times a week, but then this was something I kind of struggled to do, and sometimes it would only go once a week or maybe sometimes twice a week. But yeah, I found that every time I went to the gym and then got like at least 7 hours of sleep, the day after I felt really refreshed and I was able to focus on lectures really well, and I was able to learn the content in a much more optimal state compared to without going to the gym and getting less than 7 hours of sleep. So yeah, this is a pretty obvious one, but this is just an important lesson that I learned from my own experience. Another important thing that I learned was mental health. Now, this is something that Waterloo is actually really open about, but a lot of students actually don't take it seriously enough, I don't think. Like, I think it's really important to be open about your mental health and depression, and it's a really, really huge issue and prevalent issue that a lot of Waterloo students struggle with. In Waterloo, people really like joking about how depressed they feel, but it's honestly something that I feel like people should take more seriously, especially since a lot of people spend a lot of time studying and don't really socialize often. Sometimes the campus does get pretty dark and grim, and that kind of helps contribute to that poor mental health, I guess. People also overlook their mental health because they get stuck in the grind set, but I think it's always healthy to take a break once in a while. And the major thing that I learned is that as long as you have a lot of friends to talk to about your mental health, especially when you're stressed, it's really helpful and kind of acts as a way to replace the therapy and stuff like that. And the last thing that I learned was that life isn't fair. Some classmates are just naturally smarter, and and learn faster. And some may have come from wealthier backgrounds and may have had access to more resources. Now, honestly, you shouldn't really believe in the BS that life is fair and everything is equal, because in reality, it isn't at all. And some people are just naturally born smarter as well and just genetically gifted. But that doesn't mean that it's not, everything's not attainable for you. You just have to acknowledge that and then just work harder in different subjects and then spending less time on the subjects that I'm just naturally better at, and make up for the things that you struggle in and take advantages of the privileges that you also have. Alright guys, that is all for this video. I can't wait to see you guys in this new year after my co-op search, I guess, and then show you guys, I don't know, everything about Waterloo's co-op program and the co-op experience. Alright guys, I'll see you guys next time. Don't forget to subscribe, we're almost at 100 subscribers, guys. Whoa, what a big milestone. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Peace. 1 a.m.